What's up guys, Zain here, and in today's video, we'll be talking about notes. Most of us take notes persistently, so by the end of this video, you will be an Apple Notes super user as well. As for the coffee, we're heading back to the birthplace of coffee itself, Ethiopia. So here goes. Cheers. It has a fruity acidity and a chocolatey finish. I like it. So back to notes. Why Apple Notes, you say? Well, it's as good as any note-taking app out there, if not better. We will go over creating and organizing, formatting, and all the other tips and tricks from scanning to collaborating. Just like everything else, we need to get into the habit of organizing our notes. That starts with folders and tags. Let's start with folders. In the folders list, you can see I have a few folders. So to create a new one, click on the new folder icon, new folder. Now, name your folder. So for this one, I'll name it Travel. And then hit save, and you can see I have a new folder called Travel. You can also create subfolders. So let me create a few more folders. First, I'll go ahead and create. So let's say I want international. Hit save. And let's say I create another one called local. And save. Now, if I wanted to move these two folders, all you have to do is drag the folder. So select, drag, and drop it into the folder that you want. So travel, and let's say I wanted to drag this one as well, drag it over into travel. So now if I go into my travel folder, I can see I have two subfolders. To delete a folder, all you have to do is select the folder. You can either long press it and delete, or swipe left to right and select the delete button, and you can delete that folder. To create a note, go to the folder and create a new note. So let's create one and hit done. Go back and you have a new note. To move notes into a different folder, go to the notes and select the ones that you want to move. So in my case, I'll select these and select move and tap on the folder that you want to move them to. And boom, you can see all my notes are now in the travel folder. To sort your notes, you can tap the more button and you can see you have more options over here. So select sort notes by, and you can sort notes by oldest to newest or newest to oldest, by title, by the date created or edited, and that's the default. So for now, I'll leave it at the default. With iOS 15, you can add a tag anywhere in a note, including the title. To add a tag, select the note, then type the hashtag, followed by a tag name. So for this one, let's select travel. Once you hit enter, you can see it will change the color. You can also add multiple tags. So let's say I want this to be international travel. Tag names can be one word or separated by a hyphen or an underscore for the longer ones. For example, hashtag travel supplies. So let's say I add that travel supplies. To add a tag to multiple notes, go to the folder, select all the notes, and then on the bottom you can see there's tags. Click on tags and you can select what tags you want to apply to these notes. So let's say I want travel for this one and hit done. Now you can see all my notes are tagged as travel. When you create a tag, you can find it in the note itself, and also the tags browser, which is in the list of folders. So let's go back and scroll down, and now you can see over here, you have all your tags. To see a list of notes with a specific tag, select the tag that you want. So in this case, let's select travel. And you can see all the notes tagged under travel. You can filter out even more by selecting more tags. Folders are a great way to organize your notes into categories like work or personal. Smart folders act like filters that gather your tagged notes. When using smart folders, your notes remain in the original folder that you created them in. To create a smart folder, let's go back to the folder list and then create folder and select new smart folder. Enter the name of the folder and select the tag you want to associate it with and hit done. So now you have a smart folder and you can see any notes that were tagged with international are automatically moved into the smart folder. To convert an existing folder into a smart folder, go to the folder and then tap the more button. Scroll down and select convert to smart folder. When you convert a folder, its notes are moved into the notes folder and tagged with the name of the smart folder. Keep in mind, you can convert share folders, a folder with subfolder, or a folder that contains locked notes. And by the way, when you convert a folder to a smart folder, it can be undone. If you no longer want the smart folder, you need to delete it. So let's select convert. Now, as you can see, the trial folder, the icon has changed to a smart folder. So now whenever I create a new note, and tag it with travel, and once I hit done, that note automatically gets moved into my smart folder. I don't need to sort it anymore. Next up, formatting your notes. So let's go to a note and let's start editing it. To add formatting to a note, select the formatting button. From here, you can add a title, heading, or a bullet to the list. Let's see some examples of that. As you can see, this is the title, heading, subheading. The body text will be like this. You can have the text as bold, italics, underline, or strikes through, and also monospaced. You can add bulleted lists or numbered lists, and you can indent text as well, like so. So go back to the formatting button and increase the indent or decrease it. You can also add a table to your notes. So let's go over, close the formatting. Then let me add one here and select the table button. And as you can see, it adds a table with two rows and two columns by default. You can select the row and you can add rows or delete rows from here. And same with columns as well. So let's select a column and you can add a column or delete it as well. Tables are a good way to organize your data. To add a checklist, tap on where you want to add it and then tap on the checklist button. And there you go. From here, you can keep adding items to your checklist. So let's do some. So for my travel, I want to remember to take my passport, my toothbrush, a phone charger, and maybe extra pair of underwear. And once you're done, hit return twice. And from here, you can check and uncheck the items as well. So let's say I took my toothbrush, I got my phone charger, and you can also uncheck them. Pretty cool. Oh, and you can also increase and decrease the indentation on these checklists by just swiping. That's increasing and decreasing. And you can also reorganize your checklist by dragging the item to wherever, whatever position you want them in. Next up, adding media to your notes. To add a photo or a video, select the camera. So from here, you can choose to add an existing photo or a video from your photo library or take a new photo or video. You can also scan documents and scan text. So let's give this a try. So I'm going to start by adding a photo from my photo library and then the album that you want to select it from. So let's say I want to add this photo and select it and click on add. And that photo gets added to your notes. Fun fact about this photo. The Maasai men believe the higher one can jump, the more suitors he has available. And that, kids, is How I Met Your Mother. To add a video, follow the same steps. You can also add information from another app as an attachment to a note. For example, a location in Maps, a web page in Safari, a PDF file, or a screenshot. So let's see how these work. So let's start with Safari. Let's say I wanted to add this video to my notes. All you have to do is select Share. Select the notes. You can add it to a new note or select your current note, which will be under this, there, and just hit save. And when I go back to my notes, you can see it added to my notes. And I can even play the video straight from here. You can even add location to your notes. So let's go to maps. And I have a location over here for the park that I want to visit. So from here, let's do the same. Select more, share, notes. And again, since the last time we selected the note, it's going to save to that note. And all you have to do is hit save, go back to our notes, and boom. That's the location of the park in the notes. We can also draw a sketch or jot a handwritten note with your finger. To do that, choose a variety of the markup tools and you can select a color or a tool. Tap on the note and you can start sketching. And then hit done. And there you go. You have handwritten text in your notes. We can also scan text into a note. To insert scanned text, let's scroll down, select where we want to insert it, and then select the camera icon. Now select scan text. And as you can see, the camera opens up, it selects the text, select insert, and boom, it's that fast. We can also scan the document as well. So let's try that again. Go back to camera, select scan documents, and you can see it will select the document, take a photo, then hit save. And as you can see, it added the two texts that I tried to scan, a full and a closer. When you scan a document, it will automatically name the document with the largest text that it will find. So we can rename this by clicking it and select rename, and you can name the document whatever you want and hit save. You can also view all the attachments that were added to your notes. So let's go back to the main folder, select the More button, then select View Attachments. Here you can see all the attachments that are added to your notes. One of the most amazing things about notes is it's pretty smart. Since the document that we scanned contains the word shine, we can search for it straight from the notes. So let's go back to the main folder and hit search, then search for shine. And it will bring up that note. So let's go back to that note. You can also show lines and grids in a note. So select the More button and then scroll down, select lines and grids, and you can choose the line and grid spacing that you want. So let's cancel this. You can also pin your favorite or most important notes to make them easier to find. To pin a note, let's go back, swipe right on the note and hit the pin button, and that note gets pinned on top. To unpin it, swipe right again and you can unpin that note. One of the other cool features of notes is, let's say you had some stuff in your notes that you didn't want to share with anyone. All you have to do is select the note and click lock note. Now, since I have already created a password with notes, so that's why it didn't ask me for a password. But when you first create a note, it will ask you for a password. And after that, it will always authenticate using Face ID. To lock a note, simply click lock now and you can see the note is now locked. You can still see the title, but when you try to access it, you won't be able to see its content. To view the content of the note, simply click View Note. It will authenticate and unlock it. And that brings us to the final section, sharing and collaboration. You can add someone on any iCloud note or an entire folder of notes on your device. They can then make edits and see the latest changes you have made. If you're the owner of the note, you can remove others from the notes or folders whenever you want. To add someone to a note, select the More button, select Share Note, and then you can choose how you want to share the note. You can also customize share options. If you go over here, you can set the permissions where they can make changes, or it's a view-only note, or whether they can add other people or not. So let's go back and select Messages, and let's add a person, and then hit Send. And now you can see the icon on the top changed to let you know that you are sharing this note. To add people to a folder, go back to the main folder, swipe left, and select the sharing options, and follow the same steps again. You can also see the changes that they have made or you have made by going back to the notes, selecting the share options, and you can select show activity. It will show all the changes that you have made once the other person accepts. The other cool feature is once you go back to sharing, and select Show Highlights, it will show you who made the changes. So let's go back and hide the highlights again. And you can remove people from shared notes the same way. Go back to Sharing Options, select Manage Share Note. You can remove people by selecting their name or you can stop sharing the note altogether by selecting Stop Sharing. When you stop sharing a note with other people, the note automatically deletes from their device. So let's stop sharing. And you can see the sharing icon disappeared.
Alright guys, so that's all about notes. It's a powerful tool, and things like optimization may seem a little disruptive at first, but keep at it, and like muscle memory, it will become second nature. Best of all, it will definitely optimize your productivity. Let me know if you enjoyed this content, and drop me a line below in the comments if you thought it was useful. As always, if you haven't already done so, please do go ahead, like and subscribe so that you don't miss out on next week's episode. Catch you in the next one. Peace.